Hi everyone, my name is Tri Suhasa. I'm from Humanitarian OpenStreetMap Team Indonesia. Thank you for the opportunity. This is my first time joining State of the Map Global, and it is virtual. So thank you for having me. And today I'm going to talk about lesson learned from 4 County OSM Digitization Liberia. Before we're going further, we're going to find out where Liberia is. So Liberia is located here in Western Africa. It is located next to Ivory Coast and Sierra Leone. The government of Liberia is working on building an effective social protection by implementing a Liberia Household Social Registry in 4 counties. The data collection for this Liberia Household Social Registry requires house-to-house visits. To ensure that the data intake questionnaire is administered to all households, updated map is needed since it's last updated in 2008. HOT collaborated with OSM Liberia and ILAC Liberia to complete the mapping and perform quality assurance in 4 counties in Liberia. Those 4 counties are Bomi, Bong, Nimba, and Maryland. It is conducted last year from August to September. For this project, HOT acted as project manager, whereas OSM Liberia and ILAC Liberia acted as coordinator and supervisor for the mappers, and HOT Indonesia acted as quality assurance for this project. There are 3 stages of mapping process, but before the mapping process started, we have this pre-assessment phase. This is where we calculate initial data in those 4 counties. We also assess which imagery has the best quality and which is the most updated one. And we also check the quality of the initial data, like how many warnings and errors are there in the initial data. This is done by HOT and HOT Indonesia. After that, we also have OSM training for the mappers. We have mapping training and we also have validation training. This is done by HOT, HOT Indonesia, ILAC Liberia, and also OSM Liberia. After that, we moved on to the mapping process. The first stage of mapping process is mapping. This is where 15 mappers from OSM Liberia community map buildings and roads by county. So the first county we map is Bomi. After that, we map Maryland. And then after that, we map Bong. And last, we map Nimba County. So we use Tasking Manager to do the mapping and validation. And since the county is very big, we created the task by the district of each county.
Live streaming has stopped.
Mapper will map one of the district tasks until 100% complete. And then after that, they will move on to the next task. While they're mapping, we reviewed their work. We took notes and we pointed out the mistakes that we found. And then we told them to be careful in the future so that they won't do it again. The second stage of mapping process is data validation phase 1. This is where 5 selected mappers from OSM Liberia conducted data validation to the tasks that have been mapped 100%. After one of the tasks have been validated 100% by them, the third stage of mapping process, which is data validation phase 2, can be started. This is where HOT Indonesia team conducted data validation to the validated task by 5 paper from OSM Liberia. Lessons learned from 4-county OSM DGT session Liberia are: first, it's really great to involve local mappers because they have personal knowledge on the mapping area, especially on mapping roads. Mapping roads itself is slightly more complicated than mapping buildings. We have a lot of tags for roads on OpenStreetMaps, and sometimes we are just not sure which tag should be used when mapping roads. Moreover, roads classification in Africa is quite different. They even have their own OSM Wikipedia page. And we also found a lot of hanging path roads in the mapping area. So it is really great to have local mappers involved in this project because they will know what tag is suitable for the road they are mapping. Second, it's really useful to review the work of the mappers while they're mapping so that we can point out the mistake we found and it can be avoided in the future. Documenting the mistakes we found is also useful so that mappers can go back to the documents whenever they need. We can also give them some tips in the document. We can also give them the do's and the don'ts while doing the mapping so that there will be less mistakes found in the future. The communication and coordination were effective. We had weekly meetings. It was 3 times a week. And we have regular emails whenever there were doubts about some particular issues or ideas to share, and WhatsApp group chat for a quick check-in. All of these kinds of communication is to assure that all recommendations and feedbacks were considered and shared. We also provided a motivational package for the best mappers. We gave them an additional incentive for the mapper who exceeded weekly mapping target, and they will also be our top priority if there are any future mapping projects. This encouraged mappers to have big competition among themselves and to have dedication to complete more tasks. Last but not least, it would be better to get the new mappers familiar with mapping first before jumping into data validation. The longer duration of mapping, the better validator they will become, though it can be helped by providing a validation guideline, a step-by-step tutorial, and validation training. But it is better for them to really understand the do's and the don'ts, what is supposed to do and not to do when mapping. Data validation is not only about fixing errors and warnings found. We also need to really make sure the data quality is really good. We need to make sure that the tagging is correct, the geometry is correct, the buildings are orthogonalized, the map objects align with the imagery, all of the objects are mapped in the mapping area, etc. So it will be really, really great for new mappers to take a baby step before jumping into data validation. So that's it from me. Thank you for having me and thank you for being here today. If you have any question, please feel free to ask me.
OpenStreetMap.
Yes, thank you for your question, and that is a great question. In my personal opinion, it depends on how many time in that 1 month, I mean, you spend for mapping. I mean, if you like mapping like every day, like eight hours for every day for 1 month, then I guess you are ready to be validator. But if you like maybe mapping like for one hour for 1 day for every 1 month, and maybe it will take you like maybe 2 months to be great validator. So I hope that answers your questions.
Yes, and then the third question is, do you find any differences between the standard tags for highways in Africa and the ones that are specifically being used in Liberia? Is there any difference?
We do not find any difference between the one that in Wiki OpenStreetMap page and the one that we are experiencing or mapping in Liberia. So it's not much different for that.
Live streaming has stopped.
Okay, the last question is on how big the project was. So the person is asking, what proportion of Liberia did the four counties represent? And are there any plans that the OSM local community in Liberia and the partners of the project, are there any plans to expand this project to, say, the rest of the country or other parts of Liberia?
Thank you for the question. So the answer is, probably there will be a future project for this, because this implementation of Liberia Household Social Registry is done like gradually, and it is projected to cover the entire country in a 2-year period. So we are now only mapping like 4 counties, whereas in Liberia we have like 15 counties. So yeah, there may be a future project for mapping the whole Liberia. Thank you.
Okay, then those are the questions that we had for this session. Again, thank you so much for presenting today, and congratulations on the amazing work that you've done in Liberia. I guess the entire OSM community is looking forward to learn more about this project and the strides that you've been making on the same. So thank you so much, and enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.